Cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you.
Cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you.
Cause Uptown Funk don't give it to you. Saturday night and we in the spot. Don't believe me, just watch.
What's poppin', AC? We are back at it again to deliver some news on the upcoming events with the end of the school year, and also a few fun segments from our very own AC students. I'm Lucas Winslow, here with, well, you guessed it, Ian Lively. And let's get into some news.
Hello, this is the news. This week, I will be presenting you my top 5 favorite apps. Due to technology restrictions, this list will consist of iPhone applications only. Thank you. Coming in at number 5, I have Snapchat. While many people love Snapchat, it's not really that good. The creative features and filters put it above other apps. However, it, like I said before, it's kind of dying off. It's not really that good anymore. Number 4 is the calculator app. The calculator app comes with a sleek orange, black, and gray design. It is very aesthetically pleasing, and it is nice that the creators took their time to make it nice like this. Coming in at number 3 is Pokemon Go. Pokemon Go gives users the opportunity to catch Pokemon around town. The way the app makes users get out and be active is refreshing and unparalleled to most apps. The stylistically animated creatures are very cute and sometimes very hardcore. I appreciate the thought behind this app. At number 2, I have YouTube. Without the YouTube app, there would be no way to watch the school news. The school news is essential to Dutchman lifestyle. Therefore, YouTube deserved the number 2 spot on our list. And now, coming in at number 1, the best app to exist within an iPhone is the phone app. Without the phone app, it would just be an iPod. Also, the phone app is green.
Dude, that's a lot of apps. And apps sounds like caps. And our seniors wear caps. And our seniors. Wait, dude, did you hear about they figured out the graduation for the seniors now?
Really?
Yeah, bro.
Huh.
So basically, they're going to make our graduation into an epic movie that we can have and watch forever.
How?
Well, every graduating senior on the day of graduation will enter the school with up to 4 family members, one by one, dressed in their cap and gowns, of course, to receive their diploma. During this time, a professional video company will be recording the whole experience and creating it into an epic ceremony that you can watch and show all your friends and all your family. Isn't that epic?
Heck yeah, that's epic. Almost as epic as this segment from our very own Ben Wicki. Here it is.
Hello, I'm Ben Wickheiser with ACDN-TV, and I caught up with senior Jeremy Bors Jr. to talk about his upcoming football season, quarantine, and a lot of other things. First of all, Jeremy, how has your quarantine been going? Anything new in your life?
Yes, Ben, my quarantine has been going well. I got a new dog. I've had him for just over 2 weeks now. This is Rover. As you can see, he loves to bite. But I've also had the time that I've been able to go disc golfing a lot. Pretty much every time it's sunny, I go out just to go outside, be active. But of course, stay social distancing when I'm out on the course.
Yes, that is a cute dog. Now, I know that you are a senior this year, and having the last 2 months taken away is kind of it's a bit of a bummer, let's say. Is there any one thing that you would like to have, just one thing, like, that got taken away from you in this coronavirus pandemic?
Well, realistically, I'm not missing prom that much. I wasn't looking forward to it. It's not disappointment to me. Graduation, I've heard that we're supposed to still have some form of a graduation, whether it's a different kind or they push it back, I'm not sure. So we're not really going to miss that. I'm mostly missing just the baseball season. It's really disappointing that that got cut out because I was really looking forward to this baseball season. We were actually going to be really good, and it's just unfortunate. And the other big thing I'm missing is just kind of the whole finishing your senior year and being like, yes, I'm done with it, just kind of ending the way it did and going to online, there is no real like satisfaction of finishing and being like, yes, we're done with high school, on to college. So
yes, it is very disappointing that the class of 2020 can't finish out their senior year, but it's not all bad. Have there been any TV shows that you've been wanting to see that you are seeing now? I myself am enjoying The Last Dance, the Michael Jordan 98 Bulls documentary. What about you?
One show that I didn't even know, actually, that I really wanted to see it, but my family's been watching it, is Breaking Bad. And actually, it's my dad. My dad's rewatching it, but my dad recorded them all on the TV, and we've just been watching through them, and it's actually interesting, even though before I never really thought that I was just thinking it was not really going to be a show that I was interested in, but now I'm enjoying it.
So as a two-sport athlete at Annville, football, baseball, and I hear you lay bricks in the winter, I hear you going to LVC to play football as a quarterback. How did you come to that decision? Was it a big decision, one that took a long time? What's the story behind that?
Yes, that brick laying in the winter you're talking about is called basketball, so it is also a sport, so that is three sports. But yeah, the decision to go to LVC, I had no idea where I wanted to go for the longest time, but one day it just kind of stuck with me that I really wanted to stay around Annville, everybody I grew up with, the town I grew up in, because a lot of the people who supported me in sports, in school, in anything, are here in Annville. And going to LVC, I get to stay around everybody and just be around everybody that got me to where I am today.
Oh, yes. Well, that's very good. Is there one certain teacher or coach or any faculty member that you attribute to pushing you, giving you the biggest support at your time at Annville?
That's a good question. Realistically, I don't think it's fair to say that any one teacher has been above and beyond the rest. I think that I've realized now, coming down to like the end of the year, how many, like the end of my senior year, how many good teachers I've had that have helped me in different ways. And actually, I'm just thankful for all the teachers I've had. There hasn't really been any teachers that are just there to teach, but there to actually help you in anything that you need, which has been great, and it's wonderful. And I want to thank all the teachers for that over the years. It's been a great experience to have teachers that truly care.
Yes, we as the class of 2020 thank the teachers for all the hard work that they put in over our years at Annville Elementary, Cleona, wherever anyone went. And it's hard to leave like this, but just know that you guys are appreciated. Okay, Junior, thank you for your time, and hopefully we'll see you around. And this is Ben with Kaiser at ACDN-TV signing off. We take you to New York for our play of the week.
Wow, Jeremy Boards is awesome.
Well, Ian and I will be having our last show in 2 weeks, and we would just like to leave you with this beautiful prom video the teachers put together for all the seniors and juniors. I'm really sorry about prom. That does suck. But hey, juniors, at least you got another chance. And seniors, I hope you went your junior year. So here's the video. Have a good week, AC. Do your schoolwork, and goodbye. Yeah.